Speed, speed, and more speed. Did I mention we're going to talk about speed? We're going to talk about it in this video, so check it out. Hey everybody, it's Coach Johnson from Air TA Throws Nation. We're back and we are gonna go through part three on our how to throw the discus. In today's video, we're gonna talk about really how do we apply speed, and then we're gonna talk about that what we call as twist and wrap, the axis transition. When you're going to the middle, you're switching from your sprint leg to your delivery leg, and you're gonna get that high point, create all that tension that's gonna really lead you into that big pillar 5-6 like we talked about in the last video. For these videos, what we really wanna make clear are just looking at and understanding positions. And again, in our final video, we'll talk about the whole thing, putting together all the throws, looking at how we set up our chain reaction, how our six pillars are affected by the start. Today, we're gonna talk again about applying speed. So pillar three and four is our transition, and we're gonna create a lot of tension and rewrap. Let's take a peek. Now, we looked at our six throwers from the last video, and we're gonna continue to look at them again. And so you're gonna notice when we go through, we get to this point. So right here, this is our pillar three, and then we're gonna go pillar four. And pillar four is technically what we refer to as that point where both feet are off the ground. So what we're looking in is the drop in and apply speed. So we're gonna be able to drop and we're gonna aggressively attack the middle. That's what we wanna do. And so we look at these throwers again, and we kinda look at slow-mo and the thing that we'll constantly talk about, why we have the throwing chain reaction system. If you'd like to know more about the throwing chain reaction system, hit the link below. We're gonna look today specifically, and we're gonna look at dropping in and applying speed, attacking the middle, and then creating that transition. So that's when we're gonna create all the separation, hit the high point so that we're maximizing the radius and the stretch reflex. So let's take a look. So as we look here, now when we come around, this is why you're gonna see your pillar one and two are gonna be so critical, and that if you get those things wrong, it's gonna create a lot of problems. And so now though, so here's what you're gonna see. So when we look at our pillar three position, so now we do all this, let's take a snapshot, and now let's just throw up Sandra Perkovich, and you're gonna see that. Or let's throw up Frederick Dakers or Daniel Stahl's 70 meters this year. You're gonna see that these guys all have that big wide sweep. And now let's look at our positions. Let's look at our multi-time junior Olympic champion. Look where the attack she's really getting. She's got the nice sweep leg, sprint arm, counter. We got that nice counterbalance system. And here you have the younger athlete, really great position. Now here's the thing mechanics wise, what we wanna look at. We wanna see kind of more level hips, level shoulders. Watch the 10-year-old, level hips, level shoulders. Arguably, she has probably the best pillar three. Crystal's pretty close here. Now here's again our new athlete, pretty good. You can see that the hips and the shoulders aren't bad. Here's one of our good athletes, nice level shoulders and actually pretty good hips. The sweep leg is moving in, right? So we're starting to see that speed. So we go this way, and now we'll see this athlete a little, not bad, a little open. We're working on some different things here, but watch when we transition to four. So this is where you guys are gonna see the core things that we're looking at from a mechanical standpoint, like we just said. We wanna see a wide sweep leg. We wanna see a counterbalance system. You're starting to see how this athlete is pulling the arm around a little bit too much. This athlete has got her arm and her shoulders and her hips are kind of almost in the same direction. Here you're gonna notice the athlete's got the upper body back, and here you're gonna see that this lower body's more ahead. And this right here is where you're gonna see the transition, and this all this sets up. So now you're gonna see how this athlete comes here, and we see that pillar four position. Okay, mechanically again, what are we looking at? We wanna land on the ball of the foot. We wanna see the chest over the knee, and we wanna see a nice bend in the knee. And right now, see how this athlete's land a little straight. This athlete's close, again, the new athlete with 1 week into her full throw, doing a really nice job. Foot's a little low, so we don't want that heel to come down, but look at the position here as we get into the more advanced technical positions. We've got the right angle on the back, the left leg is moving with the hips, right? And you're starting to see this discus in a nice high point and a nice counterbalance here, and you see that real nice bend, and you see the athlete on the ball of the foot. Now look at this athlete, the problem is the hips are going out, the hips aren't underneath the athlete. So even though there's a good bend and what appears to be a good rewrap, the discus is kind of turns over, then hits the high point. But what's happening with this athlete is because we don't have those hips more under us on the transition with the chest sitting on top of the thigh knee. See, she's actually a little more bent over. This position is actually closer to this position. And this position, you can see we can't see the discus. The arm's already open and the discus is down. And now we have Crystal, right? And you're gonna see when we showed on the last video, pillar 5-6, watch how these things lead into the nice pillar 5 position. So look at Crystal at this point, look at our young athlete, and again, now you can see where the chest wasn't in the right position, so the hips aren't gonna be quite right. Now the shoulders are actually behind. And when I show you the video on pillar 1 and 2, you're gonna see that where the athlete started is the reason this occurred. Your throw is a chain reaction. That's the whole idea behind the throwing chain reaction, our 6 pillars. Identify where in the chain things are moving out of position. But again, when we're looking at these 2 pillars, the throw's already in motion, pillar 3. So taking a look one more time, when these athletes come out of their pillar 2 and they drop into the pillar 3 position, what are we going to look at specifically? We really want the foot facing in the direction. The reason we had this cone here for this athlete was over rotating, and so we gave a directional point. You're going to notice that Crystal's foot here, you're going to see, is really pointed kind of in that direction, right? So you see the foot's there. Her lower body's moving around this axis. So you've got, again, the nice sweep, long counterbalance left. Here, the athlete's sweep isn't quite right, a little over rotation. That's what we're looking for. Where's this foot? A little under rotated here, really nice here, over rotated here, and over rotated here. Okay, so the idea on our pillar 3 is we're dropping in, pushing everything into the middle. So that's why we drop in. We make a clear distinction. We're not teaching dropping down, we're teaching dropping in and applying speed. So we're gonna sprint into the middle really aggressively, and that's what you're gonna see again over here. So as that sweep leg goes wide, that allows you to push. The wide sweep is really imperative because it's gonna turn the system as you push. If you have a cutting in or a pendulum sweeping leg, you're going to eat up too much circle and it's gonna make you too linear. So you're gonna push and you're gonna go way across the ring instead of pushing and having the right leg come around and rip you into the middle. So the sweep leg, that's the object. It's gonna go on that long path, and the entry side is pushing and creating that linear path. The upper arm is really key to that. And again, so when we look at pillar 4, the rewrap has to be long and counter. And you're gonna see, again, when we look at the counter position, we wanna see how you're gonna notice that with Crystal, you're gonna notice that her lower body's moving and the upper body's, you're seeing this motion, which is what you want. You're creating that whip so you can unwind and whip into the throw. So watch as we come through out of our pillar 4, right? Where are we rewrapping? This athlete is rewrapping too early. This is body, arm is too close to the body. This arm is not rewrapping, it's opening up. This athlete's doing a pretty good job on the rewrap, and so is this athlete. So you're gonna see the differences on the better technical throws. Again, we're close, but what's preventing this athlete is if the hips were under her, that would change, right? The position of the rewrap, so that rewrap would go from not working quite right to getting the hips under, that would straighten everything out. So these are going to be some of those core mechanical things that you want to look at and understand. The alignment of the hip pulling back underneath and having that stacked up upper body, that's going to be the key. So you see this nice long position, you see the left moving with the right side, that's what you're going to do. And here you're going to see a little bit of trailing, and you can see that, whereas these guys are opening better. And you can notice Crystal has a real nice low left leg, so she's going to be able to put that down on the ground and really come around into the delivery. So again, that's kind of the core point of today's positions. Remember, pillar 3, dropping in and applying speed, that's where you do it. We're going to be aggressive, and then axis transition, we're going to twist, wrap the upper body, and that's kind of the basis. Again, we have tons of drills inside the system. If you'd like to know more about the throwing chain reaction system and dive in, click the link below. Next video, we will put it all together. We will talk about pillar 1, 2, look at those core mechanics and see again how those 2 pillars are gonna affect everything we've just talked about in this video and the last video. Okay guys, so thanks so much. Don't forget to subscribe. Be sure to comment below. We'll see you on the next video.